Hello world and welcome to a brand new Azure vlog. I hope you're all doing well. I'm doing fine. So this is more of a special Azure vlog. In this Azure vlog, I'm going to show you how we can get from this into this. Yes, we are going to build the Microsoft Sentinel logo lamp. So without further ado, let's dive into my desktop. Because here we have a GitHub page. It's hosted on the GitHub of Wortel and it's called Sentinel Lamp. We have a repository with all the things that you need to build this awesome lamp. Maarten Goed started this repo and I did some contributions to it. So the lamp consists of black and white PLA as we are going to print the lamp. A LED strip, a LED controller, and a USB cord to plug it into a power outlet. So let's start by printing this lamp. So I am using a Creality Ender S1 Pro printer to print my stuff. All the things that I'm showing you are applicable to my printer. It might be that when you have a different printer, you need to change some settings to have it working with your device. So everything you see is for the Ender 3 S1 Pro. If you have a different vendor or type of printer, it might be that you need to adjust some settings. So let's dive back into my desktop and I'll show you Cura over here. Cura is the slicer that I use to create printable files out of my STL files. I have already cloned this repository. So let's start by opening the first STL file. Let's start with the back cover. I just open it. Third thing that I'm going to do is select it and rotate it in such a way that I can print it easily. And now let's make sure arrange models that I can print it. It's now centered right on the bed level. I use my printer with the Creality Sonic Pad, so from here I can slice it and directly upload it to my printer and start the print job. I already have uploaded the models to my printer, so I will not do this. This is just to show you the right orientation of the printable parts. So the next thing that I will show you, again, let's go back to the Sentinel Lamp repo, is the inner white. So this is, if I switch back to my camera, this is this part over here, the white part that you see. It's housed in the black part. So in order to print it, I select it. And again, I select my print orientation and make sure that it's arranged in the center of the printer bed. Again, slice it and then upload it to my printer. Model is already there, so I'll cancel this. Now let's start with the last essential part. If I go to development, Sentinel Lamp, and I click on the inner reflector, this is the inner reflector. It's already perfectly aligned on the printer bed. Let's slice it and upload. I don't use any support or anything. It's just a default as it is. So now that we have sliced the STL files and uploaded them to the printer, let's start printing. right, let's start by showing you how this lamp is structured. So we have all components laying around on my desktop over here. So here we have the back plate, which is the basis of the lamp. In it, we put the reflector, and on top of it, we put the outer reflector. As you can see, let's switch over to my my iPhone camera. There are ribbles over here that you can use by pushing it gently. You can lock it in place. So this is how the lamp is structured. So I'll start by putting the USB wire through the lamp. It's a little bit tight, but I think it will fit. Yes, it will fit. And also put it through the reflector. There is some space between the reflector and the back case to put the controller in it, but with soldering all that stuff, it will not fit with my my skills. So I'll put the controller inside the light housing. So let's put this in place. Get this a little bit back. And now we can power on the controller if we want. Okay, so let's now put the light strip in it. Already have unwind it a little bit. Let's first make a rough estimate on how long it should be. Okay, somewhere around here. Let's cut it. It's done. I can remove this. Ah, that fits perfectly. A little bit too long. Nice. Let's remove this. Okay, so now I'm going to solder the light strip to my controller. So if you are like me and you're building this this project more than once, it might be that you already have a used LED strip. As you can see, there are no wires on top of it. So then you need to have some spare wires that you can use to solder the LED strip to the controller. I have them over here. I used a old HDMI cable, stripped it, and used the cables to make this lamp. So a thing that I would like to tell you before I'm going to solder the LED strip. If you look at the LED strip, and I don't know if it's good visible through that camera, so let's switch over to the iPhone. So as you can see on the light strip, there are arrows. You can see them, for example, there. And they show the orientation of the light strip. So the LED strip only works if we have our controller on the side over here. It needs to follow this orientation. So I normally start by putting some tin on the connection points. Well, let's do that. This is the first one, second one, and the third one. Looks perfect. So as you can see, we have a 5-volt connection point, a ground connection point, and it's called a DIN. And the DIN is actually the controller wire in the light strip. So I have some spare wires over here that I'm going to use to connect these to my LED strip, and from there go to my controller board. So I use the brown wire for 5-volt. Let's put it on. And that fits perfectly. Let's put the blue whitish wire to the DIN. Yes, that's also fitted. And lastly, use the green one for ground. And they are perfectly attached to our light strip. So before I'm going to attach the light strip to my controller board, I'm first going to tin these connectors over here. So I can easily solder them on the board. Here they are. Perfect. So here we have the board. We have a 5-volt pin, a ground pin, and a D1 pin. If you look on the other side, the pin is called D4. Don't know why that's different, but we are going to connect our DIN wire, which is the middle of the LED strip, to D1, ground to ground, which was the green in my case, and the 5-volt, which is the brown one, to the 5-volt pin. So let's start by soldering the wires. As you can see, I've already pre-filled the holes on the board with some tin. So let's start by attaching the DIN wire to the D1 port of the controller. And it's attached right now. Next up is ground. And that one is also attached. And then lastly, the 5-volt. It's attached then. Great. So that one is also attached. Cool. So next up will be attaching our light strip to the lamp. I'll pick the inner part. Let's put it on side. And let's attach it. This is the part that will fit into the back housing perfectly in a minute. Let's touch it. And here we go. The light strip is fitted into the outer housing. Let's remove this. Now we can attach the USB cord to our controller. That's done. And now put it gently in place. In my case, I actually ordered the wrong light strip. I ordered a water-resistant light strip, so there is a kind of rubber thing on it, which makes that I cannot bend it easily in corners. So that's why I'm just only doing the outside. If I had a better light strip, I probably would also wire it around the inner parts. So let's put this in place gently. And there you have it. Your Sentinel lamp. We're almost ready. Now let's flash the firmware on our controller and let's see how it's working. Make sure that you have counted all the LEDs of your LED strip, because we need that amount later. So we now have a Sentinel lamp, which looks a little bit like this. It's already turned on, so I've plugged in the USB cable and it's showing a orange color. So if we now go to the desktop, so if you now go to install.wled.me, that will bring us to the install page of our board. If I now click on install and select the right USB port, I think it's this one, connect, it will now flash the firmware. If I click on install WLED over here. And with some video editing, we completed that in seconds. This step normally could take a minute or so. So let's now put on our network credentials. The chip that we are using has Wi-Fi built in. So I'll give it my network name. And of course, the password. Let's click on connect. And now we can go to visit device. And that this will bring us in the WLED controller. So one of the first things that you need to do when you're in this configuration page is go to config. I earlier told you to count the amount of LEDs that are being used in the LED strip. You need to fill in that length over here. Mine is 36 LEDs long, so I've set up 36 over here. If we now go back, and this is important. If I switch to the camera, I've turned off the studio lights, so you can see the lamp right now. We can select various effects from the effect palette over here. And in order to have these effects function properly, WLED needs to know how many LEDs there are on the light strip. So let me show you some of the effects. This is the colorful effect. This is a color loop. It will change from color to color. This is dynamic. Oh, all kinds of colors. Nice. So this is how you can build your own Sentinel lamp. It's not that hard, but take time and be gentle and everything will work out as expected. So this was a lot different, this type of content than you're used of me. If you liked it, please hit the thumbs up button, subscribe to this channel, and of course ring the notification bell so you know when I've uploaded a new video. That being said, I hope to see you in my next video. Bye!